Hey there, Rebus River. Today's a sad day, and still a day of celebration. Today, my channel loses any of the LEGO 40K retro toys and other stuff like that, as I'm going to put that onto a separate channel. It's going to be called Not Just a Toy. Anyone that wants to join me there will be greatly appreciated. I am, however, going to let ads and stuff run on that channel, as I'm curious if YouTube will treat it more kindly. I have noticed that when I upload a bunch of toy stuff, I lose what I assume are people were interested in the computer gaming stuff, and when I upload a bunch of computer gaming stuff, I've lost other people I assume potentially were into the toys. So I just thought it would be less counterproductive to have them on different channels and have the notifications, unless you're really into all my stuff, in which case, you know, more notifications from different channels. Anyway, I played this game a lot when I was younger. Like, a lot. And, I'm gonna turn it down in my ear holes. There we go. It's less obnoxious. And I really enjoyed it. I've had a tiny little go to try and remind myself, and I'm gonna play as the Empire. It's a really good game. This probably won't be a very expansive slice of gameplay. Let's enjoy the tutorial. The intro. That's what one of these is. Oh, this looks like fan art that would get downvoted on Reddit. It's adorable. I'm guessing this is my ride.
I am IMP-22 Military Protocol Droid, and this is my assistant, SD-7. Imperial Intelligence has provided a briefing for you on the current state of the galaxy. The galactic information.
This is, to be fair, quite long, but you know, it's detailed and I need to listen, so shut up.
There are many systems along the rim of the galaxy which are little known to us. The rebels are likely to use these systems as hiding places from which to spread chaos throughout the galaxy.
I just unmuted my microphone to say that. Shh, pay attention. In the many years since playing this game, I've never come across something exactly like it. Just for context, the Empire and the Rebellion play quite differently. You start off with a bit of an advantage, if memory serves correctly, when you play as the Empire.
May I offer some advice?
I'd sooner you not. He's going to say
what
that a lot. Oh well. I'm going to let him manage garrisons. But that is all. I don't know. Maybe I knew that years ago. It's a bit of an awkward game, a strange interface to get used to, but effectively, what you need to do is use the various different menus to help you navigate. Looking for idle construction yards, I only have one available. It's going to be here.
May I offer some advice?
I'm going to build some construction facilities if resources are able. On another planet in this system, we have two enemy not sure what word I was going to try and say then, it sounded bad. We have two enemy planets. I think I was going to say countries, that's why it sounded bad. So I'm going to have to send the fleet in. Wouldn't mind me another system. We have some Darth Vader and some Emperor Palpatine. See what missions we can send them on. Diplomacy. Super. Senator Palpatine is great at diplomacy.
As you wish.
Indeed. And what can Darth Vader do? I'm gonna double up on diplomacy. That way, I should get another planet sooner. It's kind of like a 4X, but the planets are pre-existing with their own industries and whatnot. And you will have to win them over to your side. So the Rebellion starts off offering freedom and democracy. and we start off.
I have some advice that would be helpful.
Ooh, that's not the size of fleet ideally I would have had.
There is a message from an Imperial fleet indicating it has reached its destination.
Okay, well, let's build a shipyard if we are able. And let's check out and see if we have any idle shipyards. So I'm still very much learning the interface again, or rather relearning. No idle shipyards, which is strange, because one would wonder how we just built the Death Star. Anyway, the Imperial probe droid, I assume, is only going to be able to do some espionage. We'll call it reconnaissance, okay. Seems fair. Okay, where's this message from Lord Vader then?
I have succeeded.
So you can send them on their diplomacy missions and just basically have them continue doing their diplomacy mission, which in this instance is definitely my preference. Anyway, as with any of the sort of 4X style games, this builds up very slowly, and by the end you have like so many factories churning out so many capital ships that it becomes almost unmanageable.
One of our agents is reporting in.
Oh dear. So, this is really, you know,
we await your orders.
The star of the show. Don't expect intuitive controls here, any more so than in the rest of the game. I need to remember how to do it. I'm going to send the fighters on a capital ship
Red
attack
group
mission.
Acknowledges mission assignment.
Okay, let's observe the battle. There we go. The graphics. This kept me so happy when I was little. I'm almost embarrassed on behalf of my child itself. I promise though, when you've got Super Star Destroyers and all of that good stuff. Oh my god, as simple as this is, it still feels like something. My poor innocent childhood. I just didn't know any better. Oh gosh, I really want to see a big fleet battle now. Well, I don't think that's going to happen in this video, because I think I'm going to wrap up about here. Essentially, if you've ever wanted to take over midway through the original Star Trek, yeah. If you've ever wanted to take over midway through the original Star Wars franchise, this is probably like still one of the best ways of doing that. Sure, people talk about Empires of War, and it's a good game, and there are a whole bunch of mods for Sins, or whatever else, but, you know, this is an experience unlike any I've ever had with the Star Wars franchise. It did capture the feel of the Imperium and the Rebel Alliance pretty effectively. But God, doesn't it look ugly? Anyway, thanks for watching. There's a PayPal, there's a Patreon, there's a Steam group, if you want to support this channel. Otherwise, thanks for watching, and toodle-pip.